My goal is to convince everybody in the Republican Party, conservatives, liberals, anybody can have a chance to communicate with how important it is to support marriage between people who love one another, who want to form a family and want to form a community. I don't think it's against anybody. It's that marriage is a conservative value, and people who want to be in love and be married, that's something that conservatives should support. There's a lot of conservatives who are libertarians who understand that right away. There are some who are yet to come around. We're taking them one at a time, maybe bunches at a time, like this film will do, and we're changing people's minds, not just me, but everybody connected.
So we were initially drawn to the idea of shooting Ted Olson and David Boies when they decided to take on Proposition 8. They were the opposing attorneys during Bush v. Gore. One is the leading conservative litigator, one's the leading liberal litigator, and we were drawn to the idea of bipartisanship, and that was our initial hook to the film. But very early on in the shooting, it was a 5-year process, and I'd say in the first few months, we got to know the four plaintiffs in the case, and our film eventually transitioned to their stories, more about the human stories involved in Proposition 8 and these two couples that took on the government of California and spent 5 years challenging it, and in the end, won in the Supreme Court and were able to get married in the end.
And I think, in terms of it is kind of crazy that we're talking about these things still, but I think it's important to keep in mind that, you know, so much has changed so quickly, and 5 years ago, I think we sort of took it for granted that Proposition 8 wouldn't pass in California, and it did, so it's important to keep that in mind that, you know, while hearts and minds have been changing for a long time, there's still a long way to go. It's a really great question, and I think a lot of people just didn't expect it to happen, so you didn't see people organizing the way that they might have had they thought that there was such a good chance that it would pass. There were also outside influences that we didn't really go into in our film. The actual passing of Proposition 8, we really focused on the challenge to it in the courts after the fact, which was a little bit of a different story, but it is an interesting fact.
But if it hadn't happened in California, who knows what would have happened over the last 5 years. It's almost like you needed that shock. You know, people like Ben and I, who are gay Californians, maybe donated some money to the No on 8 campaign, but we weren't particularly active because, as I said, we took it for granted. It was polling that it wasn't going to pass, and we just assumed California's a liberal state, it won't pass. And so I think it took that type of tremor throughout the LGBT community to really activate everyone. And now you see, you know, federal judges in Oklahoma and Texas and Utah and Wisconsin this past weekend are striking down state bans. And it might have taken the Proposition 8 in a blue state like California to really amp people up like that.
Paul is my husband. We are the subjects of the documentary The Case Against 8, along with Chris Perry and Sandy Sear. We were the plaintiffs that brought the marriage equality lawsuit to the Supreme Court.
That's my story too, really.
Well, I think when we did it at the time, we don't think we really ever realized how big it would be. You know, the case really became a lot bigger when Judge Walker decided he wanted to have a trial, and he wanted to put experts on the stand and have expert testimony, evidence against, or for both sides to have a fair trial. So when he did that, the case became much bigger. And over 4.5 years, it made its way all the way up to the Supreme Court, where ultimately we brought marriage back to California, 38 million people in the largest state in the country.
You know, Proposition 8 was so damaging, and when we got the opportunity to do something about it, I think we jumped on that opportunity. We knew that it wasn't just about Jeff and I. We didn't know it was not about just Chris and Sandy. It was about the collective voices of everyone coming together to say, enough is enough. We're being treated unequally. It's time to do something. And with this legal team, there was absolutely no way you could pass up the opportunity to at least try to lean on the law that we know should protect us. And so Jeff and I kind of stumbled upon it. It was kind of accidental that we became plaintiffs, but during the process, we were surrounded by amazing people that you'll see in the film that supported us and really gave us the path to really come to victory and bring marriage equality back to California.
Absolutely feels like a big difference. You know, Paul likes to say that nothing changed in 13 and a half years, but everything changed the moment we said I do, because we felt more equal, we felt more secure, and it validated who we are and what our relationship stands for.
Yeah, saying I do changed our lives personally, but it also changed our lives socially in our association with our friends and our family and our community. You're checking into the hotel today, you know? This is my husband. We want a king bed. No questions asked. And so that's important as well.
And the interesting thing is, in California in the last year, the sky has not fallen in. So,
in fact, it was beautiful.
Yeah.
We were involved with them.
Sandy and I got married in 2004 in San Francisco, and that was revoked by the California Supreme Court. In 2008, the voters of California took the right to marry away from everyone in California. And so we really felt that there was a need to go beyond the ballot box and to the courts to ask for help with our problem around marriage equality. And 5 years ago, we filed that case, and we're here tonight to celebrate the fact that we won, that we're married, and now there's a documentary that describes that whole journey that we went on.
It is weird. It's crazy making, actually, in the state of California to have had marriage and have it taken away. And so we, like so many other couples, were really devastated when our marriage was taken away from us, and we were told, really effectively, you're not equal in the state of California, because if you can't have the fundamental right to marriage, then you don't really have some equality in your state and community. So that was a terrible time, and now we feel so hopeful for the future. Not only for we have marriage equality in California, but in so many states right now, there are actions pending that could really bring it to the majority of the country quite soon.
Well, the first time we were married, it was only conducted by the city and county of San Francisco, which was really sort of a leap of faith on the part of Gavin Newsom. What happened 4 years later was that the California Supreme Court ruled that everyone in California could be married, whether they were gay or straight. And then the voters undid that. We did not get married in that 2008 window. We waited until that passed, where we thought it wouldn't pass, but it did, the referendum. And that's when we decided we needed to go to the Supreme Court and help with an effort to get it back in California. So we had to actually get married after we won at the Supreme Court. It was, the official one was January 28th, 2013.